Assalamu alaikum, ahlan wa marhaba bikum. Good morning, your excellencies, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, and our viewers watching internationally. I'm Shireen Mitwali, and it's with my absolute pleasure this morning to welcome you to the second annual Kuwait Industrial Automation and Control Systems Conference, KAIX, System Cyber Security for 2015. Under the patronage of His Excellency Dr. Ali Salah Al-Omer, Minister of Oil and Minister of State for National Assembly Affairs, an event proudly organised and hosted by Kuwait National Petroleum Company. Now, two very important points before we get started this morning. In case of emergency, we do have a follow your exit signs throughout the doors as shown on our screens. Please do proceed outside. Also, on a second note, a lot of these segments will be, many of the segments will be in Arabic. So if you don't have your headsets are available on the far back left corner to translate. Now, it is with my absolute pleasure to start the morning with a Quran reading by the Sheikh Muhammad Al-Zura, please.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الرحمن علم القرآن خلق الإنسان علمه البيان الشمس والقمر بحسبان والنجم والشجر يسجدان والسماء رفعها ووضع الميزان ألا تطغوا في الميزان
And thank you, Sheikh Muhammad Al-Barak. Now, we're absolutely honoured to have him with us today. Please give him a very big warm welcome, the Minister of Oil and the Minister of State for National Assembly Affairs, His Excellency, Dr. Ali Salah Al-Omer.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Dear honored attendees, Good morning, everybody. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. It has given me a pleasure to welcome you all today to this important gathering of Kuwait's second conference on cybersecurity in the Industry Automation and Control System 2015. Today, with the applications of cutting-edge technologies in industry automation programs and initiatives in the State of Kuwait and other Gulf Cooperation Council, GCC, countries, we are facing some of the most complicated cyber security challenges as nation and as region. And that's why we are here today. I would like to thank all of you who join us today, members of the oil sector leadership and community, representatives from the private sector, government, academic, and consumers groups, just as we all connected like never before, we have also to work together like never before. Not only to seize the opportunities, but also to meet the challenges of this demanding and fast-growing information age. Kuwait has achieved incredible progress in many aspects and fields that we can all be proud of. However, the great paradoxes of our time are that these same technologies that empower us today to great goods can also use to undermine us and inflict great harm on our infrastructure, progress, and security. Internet hackers target the same information technologies that help make us and make our industry most advanced. Much of our critical information in our industry system run on networks connected to the internet, which is hugely empowering but also dangerous, and create new points of vulnerability that we didn't have before. Our citizens are increasingly worried about new risks and cyber crimes, and we also, as the government of Kuwait, consider the cyber threats a direct challenge to our national security. In this regard, we are working hard as a government in order to take all necessary measures and every step to shield and strengthen our cyber security by proposing new legislations and promoting the great information awareness between the government and the private sector. I believe there is only one way to defend our critical infrastructure against cyber threats, and that through cooperation between the government and the private sector and the industry by working together and share the opportunities and information as a true partner and benefactors. We have to focus on our unique strength and resources, and we need to consistently evolve with measures to protect our digital economy so that it would not fall short of its anticipated potential. To be more specific, we need to work together in order to achieve the following. First, drastically reduce the cyber crimes. Secondly, to enhance our cyber security and response capabilities. Thirdly, to support the use of internet as a freedom tool and build cyber security capabilities in Kuwait and on the other GCC countries. I believe that the key to our success lies in the cooperation among all parties. Moreover, for this we need to continue focusing in delivering tangible results to our industry and society in general. I consider this conference, which we are meet here today, is the right step in creating the awareness and enforcing the cyber security in order to ensure the protection of our industry infrastructure in Kuwait. I would like to thank you all. Thank you.
Thank you, Your Excellency. Now up next, we're going to hear from the Deputy Chairman and CEO of Kuwait Petroleum Corporation. Please let's give him a very big warm welcome, Mr. Nizam Al-Afzani.
Excellency, Mr. Boyle, Mr. State, National Affairs, Dr. Ali Saleh, Mayor, distinguished guests, a very good morning to all of you. It's my pleasure to address the second International Information and Control System Cybersecurity. This is an important event, especially it's calling for dedicated commitment to securing cyberspace and maintaining an open, interoperable, secure, and reliable internet. Our critical infrastructure, as well as sensitive data, continues to be at risk from threats in cyberspace. Let me at the outset also express my gratitude to the organizing committee and KMBC, who took the lead in this role. Cyberspace has fundamentally transformed the global economy in so many ways and features. It has transformed our way of life, providing 2 billion people across the globe with instant access to information, communication, industrial systems, connectivity, and economic and social opportunities. However, cyberspace also brings new challenges and risks and opens a new land space for businesses coming along with cybersecurity. A cyber criminal is an individual who makes use of the computer either as a tool or as a target or as both. These criminals attack, perform malicious activities such as spreading virus, data theft, identity theft. Hackers and cyber criminals can easily abuse the cyberspace to undermine our critical industrial systems, to intrude our networks, and access sensitive business and information and entities. They possibly can seek to harm our digital infrastructure and control systems, our economy, and our people. The threats are real, increasing, and they exist today. I believe that cybersecurity is the very nexus of business enterprise which need to be managed diligently and effectively. In this regard, in September 2012, an attack happened when a very sophisticated virus affected computers in two GCC's national oil companies. The viruses spread critical system files with an image and put enormous data that overwrote all real data on the machines. More than 30,000 infected computers become useless and have to be replaced. It virtually destroyed 30,000 computers, not to mention time, work, and other resources. These attacks mark a significant escalation of the cyber threat within the GCC region, and we have renewed concerns about that. Still some more destructive scenarios that could unfold at any time. Distinguished guests, we need to act proactively to get ahead of this problem by putting in place measures and resources to stop cyber attacks and have them eliminated in their tracks. We are doing this on a priority and as a part of a broader campaign within Kuwait oil sector. Our mission is to defend our digital infrastructure that supports our industrial control systems and deter any attacks. In the past, we have done so. And in the future, we will continue doing that. We will be developing the new capabilities, putting in place the policies, the standards, procedures that we need to execute our mission, train our people, and protect our networks and computer systems. In addition to that, we will build much more effective cooperation within the industry and with our international partners. I'm sure that this conference is going to be a learning and worthwhile experience for all of us. I wish you all the success to make cyberspace inherently more security. Thank you kindly for your attention.
Now up next, we're going to hear from the Chief Executive Officer from Kuwait National Petroleum Company, Mr. Mohammed Ghazi Al-Mutari, delivering the welcome address.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Dr. Ali Saleh Humair. وزير النفط، وزير الدولة للشؤون، مجلس الأمة، سيد نزار الحسامي، رئيس تنفيذي مؤسسة البترول. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. It is my pleasure to welcome you all on behalf of QIACS 2015 Organizing Committee, Kuwait National Petroleum Company, Kuwait Petroleum Corporation (KPC) and its subsidiaries. It is my immense pleasure also to welcome you to the Kuwait Second Industrial Automation and Control System Cyber Security Conference, QIACS 2015, which came after the big success of QIACS 2014, which was organized by our sister company, Equit. The cyber space and the internet in particular have become an integral part of our lives in many ways. It is difficult to imagine how we can ever exist without it, and the value and the open and free internet is still enormous. As you all are aware, the state of Kuwait, industries and government and individuals are embracing of many advantages that cyberspace offers. And our economy and quality of life are better because of it. However, our increased reliance on cyber technology make us more vulnerable to those who attack our digital infrastructure undermine our security, economics, prosperity, and the way of life. In this interaction, the digital world, there are going to be an opportunity for hackers to engage in cyber attack. Now, our first priority of business is to make sure that we do everything to strengthen our digital infrastructure and prevent these kind of attacks from overtaking place. Nevertheless, even as we got better, the hacker is getting more tricky and advanced too. In several past occasions around the world, we have witnessed that they somehow managed to cause significant and irreparable damage to the business and the security. Therefore, business today are compelled to place an appropriate security measure to combat sophisticated cyber attack threats. And I believe that QIACS 2015 is a big leap of this direction. For this year, we are emphasizing that the three main technical themes that should take place. First, cybersecurity standard, human factor dynamic in cybersecurity, and cybersecurity best practice implemented in operational technology, OTS. My friends, during the session of this conference, you will get an opportunity to learn and share cybersecurity best practices, identify gaps, threats, risk, and also address cyber security challenges. A number of presentation, technical paper will be presented by expert and distinguished speaker who will shed light on threats and opportunity available in the field of industrial automation and control system cyber security, IX. The QIACS 2015 will ensure that the participant leave the event with particular information that can be applied readily to their own industry automation and control system environment. Lastly, I would like to express my profound gratitude for His Excellency Dr. Ali Saleh Humair for his patronage for this conference, and also I'd like to express my deep appreciation to the member of conference organizing committee, all the speakers, guests, participants who take time of their busy schedule to attend and make this a learning and worthwhile experience. A special also thanks to the media outlet covering KIAX 2015. Thank you for being our partner in the success of KIAX 2015. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Mohammed Khazi Al-Mutabi. Now we're going to excuse, of course, Your Excellency and Mr. Nazara Al-Ansani due to unemployment. So thank you so much for being with us today and for your presence. Now, before we proceed, I do want to remind people our next session will have a few Arabic segments. So if you don't have your headsets as yet, they are located on my left. So the next section will have a tiny bit of Arabic. Now, over the coming 2 days, you'll hear from experts from oil and gas and numerous other industries to address critical concerns with regard to the development of cybersecurity threats. The increasing sophistication and complexity involved in cyber attacks are those specifically levied against critical infrastructure of the oil and gas industry. This has taken a progressive approach to their detection and ultimate eradication. Now, up next, we're going to find out a little bit more about the conference theme over the next 2 days. I'd like to now invite the team leader for corporate applications, Engineer Bassem Al-Shamim, please, to the stage.
Assalamu alaikum. Sabahkum Allah bakhir. Jami'an, hayyakum Allah. Good morning to you all. I am very proud to work in the oil and gas sector, especially in my lovely country, Kuwait. Everyone here knows the challenges we are facing in the market today. And in order to remain competitive in this market, we have to be innovative. The big potential to have a culture of innovation in our organization is to automate our operations. However, the price we have to pay is high in digital security. We have to protect our online assets, online integrated assets also. I invite all of you to watch the fifth dimension short video produced by KLDC.
Thank you. وافكم والله انتم كم واحد وايد خربت عليكم المؤتمر خربت عليكم السيستم كله اي ما عليك سهل علي الامور هذه انا شوسه تو انا خرب عليكم الحين المؤتمر ها خربه تحبون الكهرباء ها شوفوا ايش راح اسوي
التقنيات الرقمية سريعة التطور واليوم قطاع النفط والغاز والطاقة من أهم القطاعات الحيوية لأن شريان الحياة في الدولة كان معكم عبد الرحمن اليحيى من KNBC
يا عمي مو تخشمرتك أنت إحنا الموظفين ترقصنا التوعية لا ولنا دور مهم جدا إحنا الحين جسم للشبكة اللي من الممكن يوصل لها أي شخص
يا عمي من صدقك أنت إحنا ما علينا ضرر أنت مو تقول لنا الموضوع رقمي يعني استاذ كلها بالكمبيوتر ايش بيحوشك
بيحوشك فايروس يخليك تحدي بمكانك تفرك تفرق
يا حبيبي كلامك هذا مو صحيح اجهزه الحمايه يبينها من شركات عالميه كبيره شلون تبي احد يفترض الامن عندنا يبا ما علينا شر من صدقك
ترى المخاطر اللي بحلق عيونها علينا وايد وعال